everyone. Can you hear me now? Let's see. Can you hear me? Perfect. Amazing. Never fails. There's going to be a technical issue about the technical stuff. Alrighty. Does anyone have any questions off the bat? If not, I've got some commonly asked ones I'll answer right off the bat. Alrighty. So thank you guys for coming. I know some people are still probably filtering in. So a couple of things. I'm Laura Osteen, just in case you don't know. I've got this kind of halo above me from the overhead light. I'm the new Walter State Digital Media instructor. And just kind of a little bit of background about me before we dive into what the new digital media program is I've been teaching animation, game design, and visual effects for the past couple of years, originally at East Tennessee and now here. And I have worked on projects from short films to feature-length documentaries, special effects, advertisement graphics, and gaming assets. So I've got quite a bit of experience both teaching and making things. So what exactly is the new digital media program? So pretty much it is a associate degree that's meant to be transferred to another bachelor's program either at East Tennessee State or some other digital media based college. And there's four concentrations that you can kind of pick from. There's visualization, which is pretty much a concept design. There's game design, which is just what it says, is making games, making 3D models and assets for games. There's also animation, which could be from 2D to 3D to rigging and to simulation. And then there's visual effects, which is anything from video to simulations, explosions, all the fun stuff. So when you sign up for the digital media program, there's a couple of things that you need to know. First off is no, you don't have to buy a new computer unless you really want to. That's the short answer. Long answer for that is also yes, you might need to buy a computer in the long run. Short answer is no, because we have computers for you to use. Now that being said, if you want to work from home, you would need to buy one. That's why long answer is kind of yes. Obviously, you couldn't take the computers from the labs that you would be using home with you, but you know, if you wanted to have your own, there's a couple of different staples you would need to know about buying a computer for using for digital media. You would want to have a lot of RAM, a nice graphics card, and good processor. They can range in price from decently cheap to pretty expensive. Some common questions I normally get asked is, do I need to know how to write code? Short answer is no. Not all of the concentrations or even jobs that are in the digital media field use code. There are a lot that do. So if you know code just at all, that already gives you a leg up. So if you are interested in creating games for interaction, you would need to know things like C++ or C#, Java, or Vex, which is also pretty popular. If you're gonna use code for creating things like simulations or technical animations, things like Vex, Mel, and Python are pretty much the languages that are used. And then if you ever wanted to do any kind of interactivity in games as well, there's also something called Blueprints, which is something we go over in one of the principles courses. Other questions I kind of get asked are, what are the principles courses themselves? So pretty much they are the basic core curriculum of what you would be doing for that degree. So for the principles of animation course, we'd be going over 2D animation, 3D animation, rigging, rendering, that sort of thing. For visual effects, we go over, not explosions, unfortunately, but we do go over things like motion tracking, video, Photoshop compositing, matte painting, and motion graphics. And then for visualization, it's all concept based. So we go over things like character design, environment design, text and book kind of cover-esque kind of projects, that sort of thing. And then for game design, we make games. That's kind of the core part of it. But we also teach you how to 3D model, how to 3D print, hopefully, and a couple of other really good core rendering skills that you would need to learn for game design and for 3D modeling. Another big question that I tend to get or hear when thinking about people working in the digital sphere is, what kind of job can I get? So kind of depending on your concentration, there's many different things you can do. There's kind of a myriad jobs that kind of correspond with one concentration or multiple concentrations. For instance, for game design, you can go into things like 3D modeling, material creation, real-time visual effects, and video work. There's level design, obviously, so that you can make game levels. There's things like coding and blueprints. This is just a specific job, as well as kind of VR asset creation. For things like animation, there's character animation, 2D animation, there's 2D simulations, there's stop motion, rigging, and technical animation, which is a little bit more code-based and a little bit more math-based. For visualization, there's character design, obviously, sculpting for 3D. There's also 3D prototyping and printing, environmental design, which could be either 3D meshes or hand-drawn, storyboarding, and other type of graphics that you would find. This is the mostly 2D art-based option. And then visual effects includes things like motion graphics, short film creation, green screening, tracking and compositing of different things, simulation, that's the explosions, matte painting, and procedural mesh generation. So you can make one mesh into millions quite easily. Each kind of position and job have their own specializations and kind of take aspects from multiple different concentrations. So for instance, if you wanted to make or be a character animator, you could do that for film or games or TV or mobile. And if you wanted to create 3D models, that could be for print, for advertisements, for games, or even for films to make things explode. And then the other question that kind of goes hand in hand with that is, do I need to move from where I am right now? Short answer is no. In this kind of age of remote, a lot of people freelance. I myself have done pretty much everything professional as freelance from my comfort of my home with my cat. So you don't really have to move to a big city. Those jobs do tend to be a bit more competitive, but they are out there and they're in numbers. That being said, if you did want to find a more local art house, Johnson City has special effects houses where they make stock footage, they make films, all sorts of stuff, and that's pretty local. They also have a whole bunch of different marketing firms that use graphic artists, 3D modelers, and that sort of thing. Knoxville has a couple of game sites where you can make games out of Knoxville. Memphis is the same way. Nashville has a whole bunch of marketing firms and animation firms that are really small that focus primarily on marketing and commercial based work. And Knoxville also has a few. So there's definitely different little things still in Tennessee that you could definitely do. So small moves or long-ish commutes. And on the higher end, yes, if you wanted to work for somewhere like Industrial Light and Magic, or Epic Games, or Blizzard, or Rockstar Games, or even Weta, you would be required to move for those. They do sometimes have small remote testing options to see for applications and things like that, and for interns. But for most of those, you would be required to move out of state. But just because you've picked game design doesn't mean you have to immediately move to California. There's all sorts of local options as well. So that's kind of all of the basic questions that I normally tend to get asked. Does anyone have any questions or comments of something I didn't cover that you might want to know about? Give you guys a second in case anyone's typing something long. But no, I think overall, we're gonna have a lot of fun with the new program. And we're getting everything finally settled, and everything's gonna start up real quick next semester. But that's all I have. Thank you guys so much for coming. I'm gonna end the live now. Have a wonderful Christmas and holiday season.